Hello viewers, welcome to my channel. I'm Hashim Ali Khan. In this video, I'm going to explain you the introduction to the subject cost accounting. The first chapter of the subject cost accounting, introduction, the meaning of the term cost accounting, the features of cost accounting, objectives of cost accounting, functions of cost accounting, then scope of cost accounting, advantages of cost accounting, how the cost accounting is an aid to management, what are the objections against cost accounting. So these are the topics I've selected for this YouTube video. Normally in every examination, the first theory question will be asked on this topic only. So students should get maximum command on this topic. So watch the video till the end to get confidence on this theory question of the meaning of the term cost accounting, objectives, etc. Don't skip in between. Watch till the end of the video. So it may be a lengthy video, but it is for your benefit. I'm stressing you to watch till the end. So I'm beginning with the term accounting. See, accounting is the science of recording, classifying the transactions and events, primarily of financial in character, and the art of making summaries, analysis, interpretation of those events and transactions and communicating the results to the concerned parties so that those parties can be able to take decisions and form judgments. So in simple words, I can say accounting is the art and science of recording the transactions, classifying the transactions in order to prepare financial statements, and these financial statements are used by so many parties to take the decisions. That is accounting. So many parties are interested in the business. So accounting is the language of business. Accounting will communicate with the outside world with the help of accounting. The business will communicate with the outside world with the help of accounting. By seeing the accounts, we can judge the account, the business organization. So the oldest form of accounting was financial accounting. The main purpose of financial accounting is to prepare the financial statements. So financial accounting is concerned with recording, classifying, analyzing, summarizing, interpreting the financial transactions of the business in order to prepare the profit and loss account and balance sheet, financial statements. That is the oldest form. But there are some limitations of financial accounting. It is mainly for the external users. The external users are creditors, investors, shareholders, bankers, government. So many outside parties are there. For them, it is okay. Financial accounting is better. But for internal management, for management purpose, the financial accounting will not serve the purpose. So different new branches of accounting has been developed. Cost accounting. Cost accounting is that branch of accounting which is concerned with recording, classifying the cost in order to ascertain the cost, in order to control the cost, to find the profitability of the organization. So this branch of accounting is mainly concerned with ascertainment and control of cost. Then third one is management accounting. Management accounting is that branch of accounting which is concerned with supplying the necessary information to the management as and when it is required. So management accounting deals with all different types of accounting. It considers the financial accounting, cost accounting. It will collect the information, data, process it and modify it and make it useful to the management so that management can take decisions. So these are the different branches of accounting. Now I'm coming to the next point called meaning of cost. The cost means the expenditure incurred to produce a good or to provide a service. The expenditure incurred to produce the goods or to provide the service is called cost. Costing, the technique of ascertaining the cost of production is called costing. Cost accounting, it's the process and technique of recording the cost and ascertaining the cost of production. Cost accountancy is a very wide concept which includes costing as well as cost accounting. That means cost accountancy includes ascertainment of cost, not only ascertainment of cost but also classifying the cost, analyzing the cost, preparing the different cost reports and supplying this information to the management. So This is cost accounting. This is a very wide concept which includes cost accounting. Now, features of cost accountancy. What are the features of the subject cost accountancy? The first feature, organized body of knowledge. It's a science. Cost accountancy is a science. It is called a science because it is based on some principles, some rules, procedure. So every cost accountant will follow some principles, rule, procedure. That's why it is called a science, organized body of knowledge. Not an exact science. It is a science, but it is not as exact as other physical sciences like physics, chemistry. Those are the perfect sciences, exact sciences. But this is not an exact science because it includes a number of estimates, a number of judgments. The next come the principles, rules and techniques are all static. Next feature of this cost accounting is the principles, rules, procedure are not static. It is dynamic. Means it will change from organization to organization. The principles, rules are not fixed. It will change from one organization to another organization. That is a feature. Next one, not a single system of cost accounting applicable to all organizations. We don't have a single costing system which is applicable in every organization because the nature of organization is different. So different types of cost accounting methods are there which are applied in different organizations. Next one, it is an art, science and practice. It is not only a science, but also it is an art because it depends how to make the report, how to classify the transactions. It depends on the person who is recording. So it may change. A person may become perfect. Creativity will arise if he performs the activity of cost accounting continuously. So it will become his art. So ultimately we can say cost accounting is a science as well as an art. So these are some of the features you have to remember for writing the theory question in examination. What are the objectives of, what are the features of cost accounting? Now next topic is objectives of cost accounting. Why this subject is required? What is the purpose of this subject? Significance of this subject? First of all, to ascertain the cost per unit. Every organization wants to find out what is the cost per unit of goods produced or what is the cost per unit of service. Some organization will produce the goods, some organization will provide the service. It wants to find out what is the cost per unit. This cost accounting subject will provide the information about cost per unit. Second, to maintain systematic record of the cost incurred by analyzing, classifying or cost information. The next objective of this cost accounting is collecting the information regarding cost. Collecting the information regarding cost and classifying the cost, summarizing the cost. Classifying and summarizing the cost. That is the objective of cost accounting. Third one, to help the management in fixing the selling price. One of the objective of management is to fix a selling price. The selling price should be carefully fixed. Otherwise, what will happen if the management arbitrarily fix the selling price at a high figure? What will happen? No customer will buy the goods. No customer are attracted toward the business because the costs are high. Similarly, recklessly, if you fix a low price, what will happen? We'll incur loss. So we should neither fix a price which is very high nor very low. So we have to fix a reasonable price. What is reasonable price? Only after calculating the cost, we can be able to find out a reasonable price. So this cost accounting will help the management in fixing a reasonable selling price. To look at wastage of time, money, machinery, equipment, etc. See here. A business will be successful only when it effectively utilizes all the resources. The resources are time, money, machinery, labor, equipment, etc. The business will become successful if it utilizes all these resources effectively. If there is wastage of time, wastage of material, wastage of machine time, equipment, then what will happen? The business will not be efficient. The business will not be successful. This cost accounting will locate where there is loss of wastage of time, where there is wastage of material, etc. Next one, exercise control over stock of raw material. Every business organization have to keep a stock of raw material, WIP, finished goods, etc. So unnecessary keeping heavy more stock will incur cost. That means we should maintain only that much stock which is required for smooth functioning of the business. If we keep excessive stock, what will happen? Money will be blocked. interest charges, finance charges will increase. So in order to control the cost of finance, the interest charges, minimum amount should be kept in the inventory. Sufficient inventory should be kept. Over inventory, inventory overstocking should not be done. This financial accounting, cost accounting will help that. Then to provide cost data for managerial decisions. Nowadays, the first and foremost function of the management is to take the decision. So how to take the decision? With the help of information. Who will provide the information? Cost accounting has to provide the information. So this cost accounting department has to continuously provide sufficient information to the management for taking decisions. Next, to compute profit or loss of each product, department or process. So nowadays, the production is done in different departments, different processes. So the management wants to find out what is the profitability of every product, every department, every process. So this cost accounting has the objective of finding out the profitability at each level. Next one, to organize effective communication system, provide information at any level. So this cost accounting will help in communication. That means passing on the information from different, between different departments, because without coordination, without cooperation, it will be difficult to achieve the objectives. Last one, to prevent, to present and interpret data for management planning, decision making and control. So for functions, for properly performing all the functions of management, it is the responsibility of cost accounting to process the data, to analyze the data, to interpret the data and provide these reports to the management for effective planning, controlling, decision making by the management. So these are the objectives of cost accounting. This question will be frequently asked in examination. So after watching this video, you can be able to write in examination about the objectives of cost accounting. The next topic is functions of cost accounting. What are the activities which a cost accountant will do? So first, to calculate the cost per unit. Suppose if I am the cost accountant, my first job is to ascertain the cost per unit of goods produced or service provided. Secondly, to help the management in fixing the selling price. I, as a cost accountant, has the responsibility of helping the management in fixing a right selling price. Then, to analyze the various component of cost. See here, in order to control the cost, we have to classify the cost. The cost will be classified like direct cost, indirect cost, material, labor, overhead. So properly classification of different element of cost is my responsibility. Next one, to perform cost benefit analysis. When we are incurring some cost, there should be some benefit. So when the organization is incurring the cost on labor, cost on material, cost on machinery, what is the benefit the organization is going to get? So cost benefit analysis has to be done by the cost accounting department to calculate product level, process level and department level profitability. The organization is divided into different departments, different processes. As a cost accountant, he has to find out what is the profitability at different levels, different departments, to compare it and see which department is effectively functioning. Next one, to calculate losses or wastage. Very important function of cost accounting. What is that? To locate, to find out where is the wastage of time, where are the wastage of material, wastage of machine, etc. So, to, you know, after locating where the wastage is going on, we can be able to take the corrective measures to remove that wastage and increase the efficiency. To implement cost control system. Nowadays, earlier the cost accounting was only recording the historical costing. But nowadays, cost accounting is not concerned only with historical, but also the costing for the future. That is expected costing or predetermined costing. So this cost accounting has to prepare, has to implement the future costing, that is budgetary control and standard costing. These are predetermined costing, costing made in advance. Then last one, to ensure that capital is efficiently utilized. See here, when a business organization is investing capital, there should be a proper return on capital. So one of the functions of cost accounting is we should get proper return on capital invested in the organization. So these are some of the functions of cost accounting. The next topic, scope. Scope means domain or the scope or the area of activity. Scope domain or area of the activity. So earlier, the scope of cost accounting was limited simply to ascertain the cost, to calculate the historical cost. After incurring the cost of material, labor, overheads, we have to find out, ascertain the total cost. So earlier, the scope was limited only for cost ascertainment. But nowadays, the scope has widened. Not only ascertainment of cost, but also cost accounting. That means preparing different financial statements, different costing statements, analyzing the costing statements, making interpretation, helping the management in taking the decisions. The scope has increased. Not only that, cost control and cost reduction. Nowadays, due to stiff competition, only the fittest organization can survive. We don't have unlimited power in increasing the selling price. If we increase the selling price, definitely our demand will get affected. The alternative is control the cost. In order to increase the profitability, we have to control the cost. So cost reduction and cost control, this also comes within the ambit of scope of cost accounting. Last one, cost audit. Cost audit means checking the costing records or examining, verifying the costing records. The costing records should be accurate, up to date, correct. So all these four will come within the domain of cost accounting, scope of cost accounting. The next is advantages of cost accounting. Plenty of advantages are there for cost accounting. That is the reason why this has become a specialized body of knowledge in present times. Now, we will classify the benefits to different parties. First of all, we'll discuss about benefits to management. Cost accounting will help the management in different ways. First of all, the management can be able to find out what is the cost per unit. The management can be able to take decisions on the basis of cost accounting. Many decisions are there, just like fixing the selling price, make or buy decision, continue or shut down the plant. So many decisions are there, so many problems are confronted by the management. So cost accounting will help the management in taking decisions. Similarly, fixing the selling price, again cost accounting will help the management. Finding out the area of wastage of resources, cost accounting will help the management in locating the area where wastage is going on. In order to increase the efficiency, we have to remove the wastage. Similarly, in a number of decision areas, the cost accounting will help the management. Like planning, by preparing budgetary control. Similarly, for quotations, many a times management has to give quotations to tenders. So before giving the quotation, the management has to be sure that by giving this quotation, we must get profit. So carefully, with the help of cost accounting department, quotations can be fixed. So many advantages are there of cost accounting to the management. Similarly, benefit to the workers. The workers working in the organizations are also benefited from cost accounting. How? A proper incentive scheme will be applied in which the workers will get the share. The workers will get more incentive. Efficiency of workers will increase. Efficient workers will be honored, whereas inefficient worker will be penalized if we proper keep cost accounting. So by keeping this cost accounting systems, the workers' earnings will also increase. They'll get more bonus, more incentives. Next one is benefit to creditors and investors. Normally, when creditors or investors will invest the money, will supply the goods, will supply the funds, the creditors and investors will see the solvency of the company. If the company is solvent, the creditors, the investors will come forward and invest the money in the company. So the cost accounting will help the creditors, will help the investors by giving them assurance that the company is financially sound, solvent. Next one, benefits to government. When the company implements cost accounting, the profitability naturally will be more. When the profit increases, the government will get more taxes. Similarly, benefits to society. When a company implements cost accounting, what will happen? The cost will be reduced. When cost is reduced, reasonable price can be fixed. Reasonable price can be fixed and it is available to the customers, to the society at a lower price. So if the company implements cost accounting, the cost of production comes down. When the cost of production comes down, it will be available at a lower price to the society. So even society will also gain from cost accounting. Next comes cost accounting as an aid to management. The biggest beneficiary of this cost accounting is management. Management will get a lot of help from cost accounting. First, planning and forecasting. The first function of management is planning and forecasting. Planning means looking ahead, deciding in advance. So management has to take a number of decisions which will affect the future. In this case, the cost accounting will help the management in planning and forecasting. Secondly, control and assessment. The next function of management is control. With the help of cost accounting, the management can be able to put a control on cost of material, cost of labor, overheads, etc. So controlling all the costs is possible with the help of cost accounting. That is also an aid to the management. Lastly, decision making. So many areas are there where management has to take the decision. Like simple example, I'll give you make or buy decision. The management is confronted with the problem whether to make the component or buy it from outside. The cost accounting will help the management. Similarly, fixing a selling price. A customer wants to purchase in bulk quantity at a lower price. Now management has to take the decision whether we should sell the goods at a lower price because he is a special customer asking for bulk quantity. Again, cost accounting will help the management in taking this decision. So many areas are there where cost accounting is an aid to management. Lastly, objections against cost accounting. Some people will argue that cost accounting is waste of time, waste of money, waste of efforts. It is not at all necessary. Without cost accounting also, the business can be able to earn more. That are the objections against cost accounting. But that is not true at the present generation. For example, expensive. Some people argue that cost accounting is very expensive because already we are having financial accounting. For recording purpose, we have financial accounting. Why to keep another accounting? There's duplication of work. Lot of clerical work, lot of paperwork, lot of time, lot of resources will be wasted. But if you compare the benefits will exceed the cost. It is not expensive. Second objection, unnecessary. Some people will argue that it is unnecessary to keep duplication of work. For them, we can say it is necessary. It is not unnecessary because the scope of accounting is different. The objectives of accounting, financial accounting and cost accounting is different. Both are moving in different directions. Both are not same. The next comes inapplicable. This we can say, the same cost accounting is not applicable in every organization. Every organization is different. The nature of every organization is different. They have to study whether it is applicable or not. So we cannot say cost accounting is applicable in every organization. It may be inapplicable in some organization. Unproductive. Some people say unproductive means without cost accounting also they can produce the profit. But there is a difference. There is a difference by keeping cost accounting and not keeping cost accounting. Paperwork. Some people argue more paperwork is required. Now, due to advanced technology, we can reduce the paperwork. We can do computerized all analysis, everything. It does not improve efficiency. No, we will not agree. Definitely, cost accounting will increase the efficiency. Lastly, not dependable. Why not dependable? They are saying because it is based on the art. Because it is based on different estimates, judgments, etc. But still, even after these objections, we can say the cost accounting has more benefits than disadvantages. So this is the end of the first chapter, introduction. This part, again, I'm continuing the same thing in the second part, topics regarding this introduction to cost accounting in the next video. So if you're satisfied with my lecture, give a like to the video. Share my channel in your friend circle, in your groups, so that more students can watch these videos and increase their knowledge. And give your comments on these videos, and lastly, don't forget to subscribe my channel. We'll continue in the next video, the continuation of introduction to cost accounting.